गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, ओके। सो यस्टरडे वी वर स्टडिंग नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन अ सेट, राइट? वी वर स्टडिंग इट, वी हैड स्टडीड टू फार्मूला। फर्स्ट वन वाज n ऑफ a यूनियन b इज इक्वल टू n ऑफ a प्लस n ऑफ b माइनस n ऑफ a इंटरसेक्शन b, राइट? दिस वाज द फर्स्ट फार्मूला व्हिच वी स्टडीड यस्टरडे, राइट स्टूडेंट्स? यस। नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन a यूनियन b इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन a प्लस नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन b माइनस नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन a इंटरसेक्शन b। इन दिस फर्स्ट फार्मूला वी हैव वन स्पेशल केस, वी हैव वन स्पेशल केस। व्हाट इज द स्पेशल केस? इफ a एंड b आर डिसजॉइंट सेट्स। What do you mean by disjoint sets? That is, A intersection B will be equal to how much? Null set, right? A and B are disjoint sets means they don't have anything in common. Means A intersection B will be equal to null set, right? So if A and B turn out to be disjoint sets, then their intersection will be null set. Then number of elements in A intersection B will be how much? It will be zero, right? If A intersection B is null set, then number of elements in A intersection B will be equal to zero. So this term vanishes. Actual formula of number of elements in A union B is this. But we have special case in this. If A and B are disjoint sets, then that formula will change to be A union B will be equal to n of A plus n of B. This is special case in first formula. In first formula, what it is? N of A union B is equal to n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. But in that formula, we have one special case. If A and B turn out to be disjoint sets, then A intersection B will be null set. That implies number of elements in A intersection B would be zero. So that formula would turn out to be n of A union B is equal to n of A plus n of B. This term will vanish. So if A and B are disjoint sets, this is the formula for number of elements in union. Right, students? I hope everyone understood this. Did you all understand? Yes, did everyone understand, students? Okay, now let us go for the second formula. What is the second formula? N of A union B union C. N of A union B union C. So what is the formula? N of A plus N of B plus N of C minus N of A intersection B minus n of b intersection c minus n of a intersection c plus n of a intersection b intersection c. So this is the formula for number of elements in union of three sets, that is n of a union b union c. So this is the formula. So I hope both the formulas you have understood well. Have you all understood it, students? Did you all understand? Everyone, please answer. Okay. So we shall do the last exercise. Exercise number 1.6. Okay. Exercise 1.6, first one. So the question is, if x and y are two sets such that n of x is equals to 17, n of x is equals to 17, n of y is equals to 23. N of x union y, right? N of x union y, or n of x union y is equal to 38. We have to find n of x intersection y. These things are given and we need to find n of x intersection y. Means we have to find the number of elements in x intersection y. Now we know the first formula, right? What is the first formula? N of x union y is equal to n of x plus n of y minus n of x intersection y. Number of elements in union is equal to number of elements in set x plus number of elements in set y minus number of elements in its intersection. We know these three things. We want to find this, right? So let it take on the other side. So n of x intersection y is equal to n of x plus n of y minus n of x union y. You have just took this term on the other side. So plus will become minus and minus will become plus. What is n of x? It is 17 plus 23 minus 38. So what is the answer? What is the answer? Very good. It is 2. So number of elements in its intersection will be equal to 2. I hope you are understanding this, some students. Yes? Is it clear to everyone? Let us go for the next sum. Second one, question says if x and y, it is similar sum, so you need to do it on your own. Let us go for the third one. Second one is similar to first one. Okay, please do it on your own. Let us go for the third question. In a group of 400 people, 250 can speak Hindi and 200 can speak English. How many people can speak both Hindi and English? See, in a group of 400 people means what? How many can speak Hindi? Number of people who can speak Hindi is 250. So 250 people can speak Hindi. How many people can speak English? 200 people can speak English, right? Right? And what is the total number of people? It is H union E. What is total number of people? It is 500. Number of people who can speak both the languages is, so no, sorry, number of, total number of people. Number of people who can speak both Hindi as well as English is this, H intersection E. We have to find that. Right, students? Total number of people is 500. See, total when it comes, you have to use union. So total number of people is 500. So H union E, N of H union E is 500. Number of people who can speak Hindi is 250. Number of people who can speak English is 200. They have asked us a question. What is the total number of people who can speak both Hindi as well as English? Means they are asking us number of people of H intersection E. N of H intersection E they are asking. Right, students? So let us find it. We know what is the formula. N of H union E will be equal to N of H plus N of E minus N of H intersection E. Right? We want to find this, right? So let us take it on the other side. So what you'll get? H of N of H intersection E will be equal to N of H plus N of E minus N of H union E. I have took this term on the other side. Now we know what is N of H. It is 250 plus N of E is 200 minus N of H intersection H union E is 500. So what is the answer? What is the answer? Very good. It is 50. So 50 people can speak both Hindi as well as English. So like these questions you can solve by using this concept, number of elements in a set. I hope everyone understood this problem. Did you all understand? Yes? Any doubts in this example, students? I hope those are easy, right? Okay. Similarly, fourth one also you need to do. That is again easy. Okay. Fourth one, it is similar to first two examples. Fourth one is similar to first two examples. So please do it on your own. Let us go for the fifth one. It is not negative. How come it is negative? Just check it. 250 plus 200 minus 500. 250 plus 200 is 550 minus 500. 550 minus 500 is 50. How come it is negative? Right? It is not negative. Just a minute. Okay. It is 400, right? Okay, it is 400. So 250 plus 200 is 450 minus 400. So answer is 50. Right? I hope it is correct now. Is it correct now? Okay, fine. So fourth question, you need to do it on your own. It is similar to first two examples. Okay. Let us go for the fifth one now. If X and Y are two sets such that X has 40 elements. See, X has how many elements? 40. X union Y has 60 elements. X union Y has 60 elements. Next, X intersection Y has 10 elements. So X intersection Y has how many elements? 10 elements. We need to find what, students? We need to find how many elements does Y have. In Y, how many elements we have to find. So we know the formula. Go with the formula. N of X union Y is equal to N of X plus N of Y minus N of X intersection Y. Right? We want to find this N of Y, right? So you'll keep it here only. You take all these remaining parts on the other side. So what you'll get? N of Y is equals to N of X union Y minus N of X plus N of X intersection Y. See, I have kept this on one side itself, and I have taken these two terms on the other side. So plus N of X becomes minus N of X. Minus N of X intersection Y will become plus N of X intersection Y. So what is N of X union Y? 60 minus. What is N of X? 40 plus. What is N of X intersection Y? 10. Okay. So what is the answer? Very good. It is 30. So number of elements in set Y is? Problems are easy, right? You'll have sure question in this part, students. These are very easy, you can easily score. Okay? Sixth question is similar to third question, students. See, in a group of 70 people, in a group of 70 people means, first of all, 37 like coffee. How many like coffee? 37. 52 like tea. 52 will like tea. Okay. So in a group of how many people? 70 people. So N of C union T is equal to 70. Okay. So in a group of 70 people means N of C union T is equal to 70. N of C is equal to 37. N of T is equal to 52. Okay. Now what they have asked us is, how many people like both coffee and tea? So the question is, how many people like both coffee as well as tea? So let us, what we have to find? We have to find N of C intersection. We have to find what? N of C intersection T. So what is the answer? Can you tell me by using the formula, students? What is the answer? Yes, Saturday test you will have. on the complete chapter sets. First test, you are having just exercise 1.4, right? So on Saturday, we will have complete test on sets for 30 marks. Okay? Saturday, you will be having test for 30 marks on the topic test sets. Very good. Answer is 19. Correct answer. Very good. Answer is 19. Okay. Seventh question is most important in this exercise because it is a little confusing. So please concentrate, okay? Seventh question, please listen carefully. In a group of 65 people, 40 like cricket, 10 like both cricket and tennis. How many like tennis only and not cricket? How many like tennis? Okay, we have two questions here. In a group, 40 like cricket. 40 like cricket. And 10 like both cricket and tennis. Both cricket and tennis, how many people will like? 10. N of C intersection T. Both they will like. So it will be intersection. That is 10. And what is the group? It is 65 people. So N of C union T is 65. See students, we have two questions here. First question is, how many like tennis only and not cricket they have asked? So what they are asking? N of C, how many like tennis only and not cricket means difference will come, no? Yes, this is the first question, students. What is the first question? How many of them will like tennis only and not cricket? Means difference will come. When the word only will come and not. Only and not will come. Only but not. If this sentence comes, please understand that they are asking about the difference. Okay? So here, how many of them like tennis only and not cricket means it is T minus C. Do you all agree with that? Yes? Do you all agree with this, students? They are asking about this. How many of them like tennis only and not cricket? Is this correct? Yes? I hope you understood, students. What they are asking is, how many of them like tennis only and not cricket? Means they are asking N of T minus C. Okay. Second question, what they are asking? How many of them like tennis? So they are asking N of T. This is second question. Right? So we will